गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग चैप्टर दैट इज कॉन्वेंस ऑफ ट्रायंगल्स। इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर एग्जामिनेशन पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू, सो लेट अस नो अबाउट दिस कॉन्वेंस फिगर्स। व्हाट इज दिस? टू सेट्स आर सेट टू बी कॉन्वेंस फिगर इफ दे हैव एग्जैक्ट same shape and size. That means what? AB and CD both have exact same shape and size, then they are said to be congruent. And you have to write symbol of congruence, this one. That is the symbol of congruence. AB congruent CD. What does it mean? It means they have exact same shape and size. That means we can write this way, this side will be 100% coincide with the side AB. Side CB and AB both will be 100% coincide. Then they are said to be congruent. Now next, congruent triangles. What is this? Two triangles are congruent if they are exact same shape and size. What does it mean? It means triangle ABC and triangle DEF are said to be congruent when they have 100% coincide. On that case, we can say ABC congruent triangle DEF. ABC congruent triangle DEF. It means it will be 100% coincide. Just like we can give the example two chalks. This two chalk, although both are different colors, but they are congruent. But how to say, how to guess? Because they are coincide to each other in such a way each point of first chalk will be just match with the each point of another chalk. On that case they are said to be congruent. Similarly, we will discuss some criteria of congruent triangles. Angle, side angle, side angle, side side, 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 angle, angle, side, and one more RHS, right angle, hypotenuse, side. There are some criteria of congruence. With the help of this criteria, we can solve the sums which is based on congruence. So look here, question 1. Okay, now we will discuss angle side angle. What is this? Angle side angle criteria of congruence of triangles. Angle side angle. Look here, all of you. Angle A is equal to angle D, AC is equal to BF, and suppose angle C is equal to angle F. Then what do we say? Then you will say both triangles are congruent. That means in triangle ABC and triangle DEF, angle A is equal to angle B, AC is equal to BF, and angle C is equal to angle F, then we can say both triangles are congruent. So we can say triangle ABC congruent triangle DEF. By this criteria, angle side angle, that means what? Two angles and one including side are exactly equal to two angles and one inclined side of another triangle, then both triangles are congruent angle side angle. So we can say by angle side angle both triangles are congruent. That is the symbol of congruence. See, if both triangles are congruent, then what will you guess? Definitely both will be exactly same shape and size. Then you may write AB is equal to D. Similarly, we can write BC is equal to EF. And one more angle B is equal to angle E. These are the CPCP terms. That means what? That means congruence part of
third.
Yes. So AB is equal to D, BC is equal to EF, and angle B is equal to angle F. These are the CPCP terms. Corresponding part of congruent triangles, because both triangles are congruent. Which criteria? By angle side angle. Now we are going to start one sum which is based on this criteria. Okay, what are the questions? Question 1. AB is equal to AC. Prove that angle B is equal to angle C. How to prove? If AC, AB is equal to AC, prove that angle B is equal to angle C. Whatever question we have, especially in this chapter, firstly we have to knit two triangles, but there is only one triangle, so definitely you need to construct, then you can solve it. So first we will write given terms. What is given? Given terms AB is equal to AC. After that, what I have to prove? Write down TPP. TPP means to prove that angle B is equal to angle C. And after that, you have to write construction. Construction, if there is no two triangles, on that case, you have to knit construction. So draw the construction this way, right here, and draw AD perpendicular BC. After that, you will write proof. Whatever question may be, you have to start this way. First, you will write the given terms. Secondly, PPP. Thirdly, construction according to need. And fourthly, proof. After that, you have to take two triangles ABD and another one ABC. ABC. Take two triangles ABD and ADC. What is given? Mention again. AB is equal to AC. Right here, given. After that, you have construct drawn AD perpendicular BC. Then it will mention in the figure. Otherwise, it will be wrong. As well as AB is equal to AC. AB is equal to AC. So it will mention in the figure. Otherwise, it will be wrong. What is given, you will mention in the figure. If not given, don't write equalized angles or equalized side. And then AB is equal to AC. Next, angle ABD is equal to angle ABC. How is possible? Both angles are equal. As well as you will write 90 degrees. How? By construction. Because you have constructed to solve this. After that, one more thing you have to write, raise your mind, that is AD. AD is equal to AB. AD is equal to AD, why? Because AD is just common in both triangles. Here AD, AB here, and here is also AB. You can guess, you have taken two triangles. In both triangles, AD is common, so you have to mention AD is equal to AD, as well as you have to write here common. Once again, we will discuss further the question. Question is given, if two sides of triangle are equal, then prove that their opposite angles are equal. Two sides are equal, prove that angle B is equal to angle C. How to prove it? To prove it, firstly, write down the given terms. Secondly, PPT, angle B is equal to angle C, we have to prove. Thirdly, construction. Why? Because there is no triangle, two triangles here, so we need to construct. So draw AD perpendicular BC, and then we have to take two triangles here, and then write down the given terms which are given, but this one is not given. ADB is equal to ADC 90 degree, and then AD is equal to AD. After that, we can say triangle ABD congruence triangle. A, B, C. By what? You have to guess. Which criteria have to apply here? Just this side, just lying opposite to the 90 degree, the definitely will be hypotenuse. That is 90 degree. So mention here, AB is equal to AC, that is just hypotenuse. ABB and ADC, that is right angles. And third one, that is sides. So both triangles are congruent, ABD and ADC, by RHS. It implies if both triangles are congruent by particular criteria which has been discussed already, then we can say angle B is equal to angle C by CP, CP. Why these angles are equal? Because both triangles are exactly congruent by some criteria of congruence rule, that is RHS. RHS congruence, we can say RHS congruence. So angle B is equal to angle C. Proof. Okay, that's